Hi, Greg Cylkowski, sports analyst with Athletic Achievements. We're coming to you live today from the sunny, sand-soaked beaches of Lake Phalen on St. Paul's historic east side. We're going to bring you live not only the All-American Volleyball Camp, but its season-ending Sandblast Volleyball Tournament. Should be fun, should be exciting. We have some coaches, tips. Hey, we're just glad to have you. Enjoy the day.
Hello everyone, welcome to Lake Phalen and a beautiful summer afternoon here at the beach volleyball court as we present the All-American Volleyball Camp, presented by Greg Cylkowski of Athletic Achievements.
Hi, I'm Lydia. I play for White Bear High School, and today we're playing for the women's game. And a fun fact about myself is I have a secret obsession with the House and Garden Channel.
Hi, my name is Maggie Mueller, and I am playing Sand Beach Volleyball. I'm going into ninth grade at White Bear Lake North Campus. I love shopping and playing volleyball.
Hey, I'm Annie. I go to CDH, which is at Cretin-Derham Hall. I like volleyball because it's just fun, and you get to play with your friends and have a good time. Beach volleyball is fun because of summer, and just get out there and have fun.
What up, my name is Ciara. I play volleyball. I go to North Campus, White Bear Lake High School. And I love to pass and hit.
Hi, my name is Breaunna Lyell. Everybody calls me Bree. I go to St. Paul Central and my main position is setter. I've been playing since I was 4 years old and I live, breathe, eat volleyball. Yeah.
Hi, I'm Maya Hedstrom. I'm gonna be in 10th grade at Central High School. And I've played volleyball since fourth grade.
Hi, I'm Hannah Wolf. I'm a middle hitter at Central High School.
Okay, hi, I'm Savanna Handevidt. I've been playing volleyball for like 7 years competitively for the junior highs and the high school. And I will be a senior.
Hi, I'm Julia Walfoort, and I go to Cambridge-Isanti High School. And I've been playing volleyball for 6 years now. And I really love the game. I enjoy it. I'm planning on playing in college, probably D3, but still, it's something. And I just really enjoy the game and all the people that I've met, and I've learned a lot over the years, and I really enjoy the game.
Hi, Greg Cylkowski back again. I also have the honor to serve as the executive director to the Sports and Life Foundation, a nonprofit group dedicated to providing academic, athletic, cultural, and personal development opportunities for kids in the inner city and urban communities of Minneapolis and St. Paul. Today we're at the All-American Volleyball Camp, and for the 15th year we're very proud to sponsor one of the most unique summer camp experiences. Not only do we have the opportunity to work with women from grade 6 to 12, but in our quest to grow the game for men, we now have a co-ed format. And later today you're going to be watching the boys and the girls compete together. Also, we are very proud of the fact that we have the highest number of kids of color attending our camp. We do so by providing financial aid scholarship opportunities, again, something not offered anywhere in the Midwest area. So, co-ed volleyball, financial aid scholarships, an outdoor training format to make this a lifelong endeavor, sports and life, dedicated to opportunities, creating fun, and just making this a little better place in today's world.
Yeah! after the block.
Okay, so, Bree, make sure when the right side's hitting, you're pulling off, like I said over there.
Okay.
You're pulling off and taking a shot.
Yeah.
All right. Savannah, where are we at? When our left side, their left side's hitting, you've got a shot.
And we rejoin you at Lake Phalen for the All-American Volleyball Camp. I'm Mike Peden here with Sara Thingvold, a volleyball coach, and we have got the All-American girls in blue and Team KDWB in black. And I understand our match is underway, and what is the score right now?
I'm not sure. 7-4.
7-4 in favor of the All-American girl team, and we're playing up to 21 for match, and right now we've got KDWB serving out of bounds, and with rally scoring, that gives the All-American girls an 8-4 lead. Annie Ryan from Cretin-Derham Hall.
From Stillwater.
The ball drops on KDWB's side. All-American girls.
So we are playing with side out.
We are.
Yep. It's rally score. 9 serving 4.
All right. And make it 10-4.
All-American girls.
Now, perhaps you can describe the difference between standard beach volleyball and traditional volleyball.
Traditional, yeah. So, you know, beach ball and traditional, they each have their own beauty to the game. The rules, as far as tip rules, they're different for beach. The beach game, they can't have an overhand or an open hand when they tip the ball. They have to be facing square to the net when they push the ball over. It's definitely who can hit the ball type of a game. Who can side out with finesse. A lot of the sandball game is finesse and ball control, much more than the court.
And we're trying to communicate a side switch. Well, we switch at 13 and not 11. The All-American girls, it's Lydia Anderson from White Bear Lake, Lauren Simonson from Hill Murray. And right now we've got KDWB going at it. And ooh, nice dig. Savannah going for it and gets the kill.
Back in the one position, the right back.
Savannah Handevidt from Stillwater. The score.
Service short ace. Serve.
And on the serve was
Julia.
Julia Walfoort.
From Cambridge. Now Julia, she plays a lot of junior ball. Some of these girls here, they'll play junior level USA B ball. So some of them play the top elite level, and some of them play, you know, that isn't that top of an elite game. Some of them travels nationwide. Okay, we got another point side out. For the All-American girls.
And their roster, Lydia Anderson from White Bear Lake, Lauren Simonson of Hill Murray, Annie Ryan from Cretin-Derham Hall, and Ciara McKee from White Bear Lake. All American girls of the dig. And Doug right back. And Savanna talking
by Lydia.
Savanna talking about the sun. That's one element affecting play today. Inbounds and a point goes to KDWB.
Yeah, you know, as far as the sun goes, I mean, that's another difference of beach. You know, a lot of the times you get the sun in your eye and you won't have that inside.
At least it's not raining. So Savanna Hanville serving.
So you're gonna get a lot of finesse in this game. If you're gonna hit a side, if you wanna hit a side out, definitely hit the deep corners. That's almost a guarantee, side out.
And now we rotate with the score at 13-9 for the All-American girls, but they're playing the point. This isn't a strict AVP rules match today.
Exactly.
And Julia just went out of bounds, making the score 14-10. And now we are switching sides. We were going to get that switch in eventually, and we're playing, is it best of one, best of three, or?
Right now we're playing best of 1-21 with a 23 cap.
So this match will be over just as almost by the time it begins.
You know, that's another switch that they've had in the last 10 years or so is rally score. It really keeps the game moving, fast pace.
Walfoort, nice. Hannah Wolf from St. Paul Central.
You know, for the court, for sandball, you have different sizes. So you have your tall girls, your short girls. But in sand, even the short girls are very effective because a lot of times the tall girls, they get caught up in the sand. So it can be very competitive.
Bree Lyell setting up, and the kill attempt is short. For the KDWB team, it's Hannah Wolf from St. Paul Central. 16-10, our score in favor of the All-American girls. Julia Walford from Cambridge, Maya Hedstrom from Central, Bree Lyell from Central, Savannah Hanville from Stillwater. And it's now 16-11. I can tell you the sun's even affecting us.
Yeah. You know, these girls are doing a really nice job since hardly any of them know each other and play together.
And chemistry is a big element in sports, regardless of the level. And that ball was going to head for the pond, but that's why we've got balls.
Fabulous ball shaggers, ball line girls to help us.
I know I'm not in position to go for a swim. Lyle with the serve. Oh!
Nice try.
Little miscommunication there, and so Ciara wasn't quite ready for it, as I think it was Lydia. Lydia was going for the pass and mistimed it, bounced off Sierra's head. This time Lydia gets the pass, but it goes out of bounds. So right now it's 16-14. 2-point match.
KDWB girls are catching up.
And they're getting another ball. Bree Lyell to serve. Just out of bounds. 17-14.
Hey, let's go, guys. Good job. Keep it up. Keep it up.
We do not have the benefit of jersey numbers to help us. But Hanville sets up. Lyle with the pass. And it goes out of bounds with the point attempt. I believe was Walfoort?
No. Yeah, by Julia.
Way to go, Sara.
And it just went wide. Anderson to serve. Out of bounds.
Would that be you?
thing that you notice about the team play here is that everybody is attacking the ball. So you have one main setter, but all three of them are attacking. Whether or not they're left side, middle, or right side player, they're all going to attack the ball. Or defense especially.
And speaking of that, I believe that was Annie Ryan who got the point.
Yep. Annie, all American girls, they're all 10th grade. They're a young team. They're doing really well.
They're 2 points away from winning this one-set match. The KDWB strikes back, making it a 19-16 score. Again, you have to win by two with a 23-point cap.
There's that let serve. You know, in volleyball, if the ball hits the net, the top of the net, and it still goes over, you can still play that ball up. And that's pretty tricky. It catches up a lot of teams.
And that, and that works out to the All-American girls' favor. They're 1 point away from winning this match. Lyell to set up. Walfoort. And it's dug by Ryan, but couldn't find a receiver. And now it's 20-17. KDWB has got to get three more points to prevent a match point. Well, there's match point.
People ask us all the time, sand volleyball, grass volleyball, hard courts indoor. I'll tell you what, as a sports analyst who works in player development performance, I just really enjoy having three sport athletes and crossover training. The benefits you have from playing the outdoor game and the grass game is you have to sometimes look in the sun. You have a little heavier ball. You have to learn to explode off of that sand, and you've got to move those feet. So the benefits that you have from the outdoor game not only will make you lighter, faster, and more focused on the indoor game, but now you have a great opportunity to have a 4 or 5 hour day in the sun, not very expensive, and you can play anytime, any place. We're behind grass ball, sand ball. Enjoy outdoor volleyball.
Mike Beaton here with a few camp participants that took place in our earlier match today. So why don't you go ahead and tell us who you are and what you like about volleyball?
I'm Emma Goddard, and I like just playing the game. It's just so much fun just to play volleyball.
I'm Rose Coughlin-Smith, and I just like being on a team.
I'm Sonia Adelgren, and I like setting and playing with my friends.
And are you a player?
I don't know. I'm supposed to be the camp director, but they're kind of fun to hang out with. They like the shade. They have a lot of fun. They're always trying to get my T-shirt, see? So, no, these are great kids. We had a really good week. It's a good way to wrap it up.
And what do you think of the action so far in this older game?
It looks like it's been a tough match, but we'll see what happens.
They're really good, and it looks like a lot of fun.
It's really fun to watch, and they're really competitive.
I'm really impressed, I'll tell you. I thought the younger girls, I'm really impressed with our nice All-American blue T-shirt team. No, they're playing very well because they're playing a very senior-dominated group with KDWB. And so I'm hoping these guys will bring their team together next year and they'll be in the finals.
Yeah.
And tell us, you know, what attracts you to volleyball out of all the sports you can play?
Everything. It's just such a fun, welcoming sport. Everybody would want to play volleyball, I guess.
I like the spiking.
It's a great game. You can play with your friends just for fun or competitively.
And what about you?
It's a great lifelong game. That's why we bring them out to the grass and the sand. I think the training benefits outside is great, but also not just the benefits, but it's a lifelong sport. A beautiful day like today, you don't have to be in a hot gym. It's a great way to enjoy it.
All right, our timeout is just about to wrap up, so we got to go back out, but thanks for speaking with us and enjoy the matches today.
Thank you.
Thanks. You're welcome. You too.
Stay cool.
And back here, Sara Thingvold will join me shortly. We did find out it is a best of three. And so the All-American girls have a 1-0 lead in this match. So Sarah's just joining me back in the broadcast booth. I will not be requesting you for my mathematical homework. I'm kidding. It's all in good fun. And right now, KDWB is starting with an early 2-0 lead in set number two.
All right, here we go. The All-American girls are playing another game. 21 is the... playing to 21, 22 for cap.
out, service out. Side out, All-American girls.
And of course, with rally scoring, there's a point on every play, so we change serve, All-American girls with their first point in this second game, this second set, whatever this is. And Anderson short on the serve. That puts a point back in KDWB's pocket. It's 3-1 in game two, set two.
And who's the girl?
And it looks like Bree Lyell is taking a seat. And in her place is Maya Hedstrom from St. Paul Central. And Hedstrom setting up for Walfoort. Anderson with the dig, and her spike attempt is short.
You know, in the sand game, you really have to make sure that you can't snap too close to the net and stay off the net, or it's going to go right in. It's a higher net.
Just at the ground, Walfoort with the point. Or is that Wolf? I'm still learning the names. Walfoort, yes. So, and Handeville short on serve. That makes the score 5-2 in KDWB over All-American girls in this supposedly best of three match. Out of bounds. Wolf. I mean, that was Wolf trying to set up?
Yes, that was. And you could see her feet. You know, it's not, again, it's not court ball. Her feet got all twisted up in the sand. She couldn't quite get them in place.
The sand, an uneven surface, and that can affect the grip of the players. As Ciara stops, but net touch.
It really makes a ball that looks like an easy free ball get caught up. And that's what happened.
So one element of unpredictability you don't see in the traditional court volleyball game. As Walfoort going for it. Anderson there for the stop. And we're getting a big rally going. Handeville goes out of bounds. I jinxed her.
That was a nice volley. The girls kept the ball. Their arm swings were high. Their hand snaps were high. And they kept the ball in play. Ball control is the name of the game here.
6-4 in set two in favor of KDWB. And just a little mistiming there.
Yeah.
Maya Hedstrom, 4'11", sophomore. The shortest player in this competition, but height doesn't necessarily mean everything in volleyball.
No, you know, when I played at Nebraska, we played Ohio State. Ohio State did not have, you know, very much height at all. But, you know, we ended up losing a couple of those games because they were fast on defense. They had great ball control. So height doesn't always mean that you're going to win.
Substitution, Hedstrom going out and Bree Lyell taking her place. And great, nice try by Lyell for the save, but give credit to Anderson, I believe, for throwing Lyell off guard.
That's right. Great placement. She had really good placement. Right in the 10-foot line right there.
And serving, I believe, was Handeville going. McKee with the stop. Touching the net again. And that gives another point in KDWB's pocket. Sometimes just geography, sometimes you forget where you are.
Yeah. When you're on the sand. That McKee, not much can get past her. She is just digging up the storm.
Preventing a lot of aces for sure. And another dig.
You can definitely tell that the girls have warmed up from their first game. Their volleys are a lot longer, a lot more ball control.
And we're getting Tanner.
Exactly.
McKee, stopped by Wolf. Handeville, another dig. And that goes out of bounds. That kills what was a solid rally and a lot of great digs there by Ciara McKee out of White Bear Lake. 9-6 KDWB over All-American girls. 9-7 now after Handeville was short on the serve in set number two. If they do this again, I would suggest adding numbers to the jerseys, or names at least. There's Lyell going to Walfoort. Anderson, and it's going to be, McKee gets it in before the four touches. You're allowed to touch up three times, of course, in volleyball. Now Anderson going for it, and it's dug right away by Walfoort. Neither team can really get a good spike going, and that's just going to go over the net and inbounds. Well, sometimes it's better to be lucky than good.
Exactly, and if you watch the girls volley, they're so smart. They have to push the ball, and they're pushing it to the deep corner. It's just very smart team play.
Lyell touched the out-of-bounds line, and that ties the score here in set number two. Anderson serving. Walfoort setting up. Lyell to Walfoort. And another net. Another trick or a luck play. Again, the let serve, the let ball. If you can master that shot, you'd be a millionaire.
Exactly, exactly. When that ball hits the top of the net and it drizzles over, it's hard to predict where it's going to land. If the girls are caught on their heels, you got to stay on the balls of your feet.
And that can happen regardless of the surface. That gives KDWB their 10th point. Ooh, they mistimed that. That gives a chance for KDWB to set up, but Handevidt can't get in solid position for it, and that's going to go out of bounds. And that's because KDWB now holds an 11-9 lead over the All-American girls in this second game, the second set. Best of three, we believe. We're kind of ad-libbing this as we go, but it adds to the unpredictability. And now it's 12-9. In favor of KDWB. The first set was won 21-17 by the All-American girls, if you just joined us. And serving is Wolf. A lot of St. Paul Central competitors on this volleyball team, as Walfoort, there's a little miscommunication on that volley as they were preparing to serve over the net, and it just messed up the timing.
Yeah, and what happened was their setter, she took the first ball over. You don't want the setter to take the first ball over. She's your quarterback. You want her to have the second ball.
Hedstrom serving to Handevidt, and McKee once again. If there was such a thing as libero, I think McKee would fit the definition. And that's off the net, but that's still live. And Handevidt there with the dig. And that goes out of bounds. Give credit for the awareness on the All-American girls. McKee hit the net, but it did not hit the ground. And that's illegal. All-American girls give credit to their poise. Hedstrom setting up to Walfoort. Lydia going for it.
Another thing that's key to remember is conversation, talk. They got to be talking to each other. They got to be calling the ball, who's got the ball, who's taking the set, who's going to be attacking it. When the ball is rapid fire like this, it's just, if there's not an awareness of who's going to hit it, it's going to hit the floor.
Greg Cylkowski, the organizer, stopping by. And that is... just hit the line. Ciara McKee thought it would sail out of bounds, but the wind not that strong today.
Well, I got to check out my new star clinician. Sarah's been a great addition this year. And we talked about the concept and philosophy of the camp and the tournament. She was just raring to go, and she's what we're looking for. She really complements what we're all about. And I'm very impressed with the blue team. I thought on paper, I told Sarah, I think this is going to be a good match with the older girls, but... again, I think it goes with what Sarah's been saying all along. There's great equalizers, and they're really doing the little things to make this a great match.
14-12 right now. Lyell with the dig. Walfoort setting up to Handevidt, who's a little too strong, and that makes the score 14-13 in favor of KDWB.
Now, Savanna, who's from Stillwater here, she's your all-star basketball player. Volleyball is her second, or third sport, actually. She's lacrosse. So here you have three sport athletes playing the game.
And it's not uncommon for a lot of these high school players to participate in more than one sport. Some will sit back if they have a scholarship offer on occasion.
Believer. I'm a very big believer as a performance coach. You look even like Joe Maurer, Paul Molitor, who I went to school with, they all play three sports. Chris Winkie, who was a Heisman from Cretin, three sports. In fact, what's really interesting, now these guys are very competitive, but Chris Winkie to this day said one of the greatest thrills he had was getting to the state hockey tournament his senior at Cretin, and here he is, a Heisman Trophy and an NFL player.
I was going to mention, Laura Gibmeyer did take her senior season off from the other sports because she had a volleyball scholarship, but some will brave injury and, you know, just, hey, you're in high school one time, so you got to make the most out of it.
Well, and I also think the burnout factor, too. I like kids that have snap in their legs. So many kids by 16, 17, they're not even here. That's why even our camp is a lot younger now. At the low end, they're spending so much time. So I think your competitive side is better playing three sports. But I also think you're fresher. You're raring to go when football season comes. You're raring to go when volleyball season comes.
15-15 in set number two. And Walfoort just painted the corner. Well, that's another trick shot that you could be a millionaire if you master.
Exactly. She got the deep corner. Those are deadly. If you can hit that corner, you're going to get a point.
Also showing where these girls, the younger girls, are not used to playing fours. I love fours. It forces you to cover the court. Now, they're not used to covering it, and they're kind of just standing there hoping the deep was going to get it. There's nobody home. So, see, I think if you take these girls maybe a couple more matches or a couple weeks from now, they would have made that play. I really believe that.
And Olympic beach volleyball is only two at a side, so that's a lot of court to cover. Right?
Sarah and I were talking a little bit too. I like the fours. When a woman had the Bud Light fours, I found it more exciting, more fun than the twos. And I know what Sarah thinks, but I enjoy the fours better as a spectator and a player.
If it's a sport, I'm there.
Yeah, and actually, I like the twos. There's nothing like digging a ball, getting up, getting set, and ripping it down. It's just a thrill. We talked about that this week at the camp, and one of the boys comes over to me and he said, "You're right, that's an awesome feeling."
Well, Michael, you can see why she says that. Now, I'm the little guy who, like Angie, is the scrambler and likes to do it. And, of course, she's the big hitter, like Barb, who likes to just, you know, cream us. So now you know why she likes twos and I like fours.
2, 4, 6, if it's a sport, I'm there. Score right now is 16-17. All-American girls making a comeback here as they now lead set number two, but we had double touch.
I'm really impressed with the All-American girls' defensive plays. They have really played hard. They really have. I think it's the coaching from Sarah this week. I think that's what it was. And she's not negotiating a new contract already. I mean, you know how sports are.
And more impressive, in particular for the All-American girls, as they take an 18-17 lead, is they have more players from different schools. The 1.3 team, they have three from Central, and they've got Handevidt from Stillwater, Walfoort from Cambridge.
We just had a switch here. Maya just came in for KDWB.
And Maya and Lyell have been switching off throughout this second set.
Yep, and they're both setters. So all they're doing is flip-flopping setting at the server position.
Well, Lyle's one of our real success stories. First 2 days of camp when we were at the Oxford Jimmy Lee Fieldhouse, she didn't even know we were there, and she was working, and she just joined our camp yesterday. And she's been a great addition. And again, that's what this camp is about, getting kids to play, giving them new opportunities, and Lyle epitomizes that.
Game point. KDWB has a chance to nod this up at one set apiece. 20-19, out of bounds. That makes the score 20-20. Again, we play to a 23-point cap. So this next point is critical. Ciara McKee to inbound or to set, serve. I'm thinking basketball. I'm covering that later. Hedstrom serving to Handevidt, and it's Doug. And who's that on the going out of bounds?
That's game, KDWB.
KDWB wins the second game after Annie Ryan's attempt went out of bounds, so that gives us a quick 30-second break, and that will put us to set number three, I believe.
That's right. Yep, this is going to be the game match winner.
Mike Peden here with Zhang, and the City of St. Paul lifeguard staff, and it's a beautiful day out to be in the beach, and I'm sure a lot of volleyball players are coming in here to cool off, so what are some tips that they can take to ensure their safety?
Tips is to definitely drink water, because you always want to stay hydrated on a hot day like today.
And what about pool safety? You know, what's the age, and when should kids wait for a lifeguard to go out?
Pool safety, I mean, any age could come out. It's just right here, we're open 1 p.m. till 7 p.m., so whenever a lifeguard, it's always safe to have a lifeguard around, so whenever there's a lifeguard around, you can always come swim here. So.
And even with the lifeguard, what are some ways kids can make sure they're safe when they're out here taking a swim?
Well, if they don't feel so safe, they can have life jackets. We do have life jackets available for kids who can't really swim out here too, so.
Well, we've got six people who make sure kids who decide to take a great day and go for a swim are safe and have a lot of fun. And we thank you for your service and what you provide for the City of St. Paul.
Oh, thank you for coming out. Glad to have you.
Thank you.
In sports, everything starts with the feet. In serving, everything starts with the toss. In order to make your number one offensive weapon work for you, you have to have a consistent, soft toss that you can make great extension with. So if you want to be a great server, get that toss up there. Enjoy the game. Keep it consistent, and you're going to win and score.
So why don't you go ahead, just tell us what you think of the match so far.
I think it's great. I think it's an awesome opportunity for the girls to play beach and sand. It's a gorgeous day in Phalen, at Phalen here. This is my daughter Melissa, who plays in Iowa. She plays Division II volleyball for Upper Iowa University. And so a lot of traveling. You want to talk about that at all?
My whole life. Those are my brothers, the Giants out there.
So it does run in the family quite a bit.
Yes.
What do you like about volleyball, beach court? What's attractive about it?
Just a fun game. It's not, I don't know, basketball is always fun, but it's a little too much pressure. This is just a fun game.
Thank you for speaking with us. I got to get back over there and call the third set. But the Walfoort family over here supporting this All-American Volleyball Camp as I return with Sara Thingvold here at this volleyball court out in Lake Phalen. Beautiful day. We begin set number three, the money set. And we start with the point for KDWB after a service error, I believe, by Lauren Simonson out of Hill Murray. Hill Murray known for their basketball program. 20-30. Walfoort serving. And give credit to Walfoort, she really stumped McKee as she tried to dig.
Yes, she did. She did a really nice job. You know, even when you're blocking at the net, it just keep your hand up and flat, and if they come to hit down, it's going to pop off the top of their hands so that they can make a play.
Simonson to Anderson, and it goes out of bounds. And will the ball Lions person get it before it goes into the lake? Yes. Fortunately, they've got spares. Walfoort serving again, 3-0 in favor of KDWB in set two, and look out! Hey, wait a second, this is kickball, not volleyball.
Indeed.
Four straight points for KDWB, make it five. A big rally for the KDWB all-girls team.
When their footwork, when they're going to step back there to serve. You know, again, just like inside game, you can serve anywhere back alongside the court. But sand, your feet, some places are hotter than others when you're standing. Some places you sink more than others. So just getting your good foot in place and stable is a big key factor when you're going to serve the ball back there.
Walfoort going for it. And it's dug by Ryan. Now McKee sends it over to the KDWB side. Handeville with the touch. And a nice effort by Anderson, but Anderson touched the net again. That's the third time, I believe, the All-American girls have touched the net. And sometimes position, you can get thrown off.
Yeah. That sand, I tell you, stepping it wrong, and it's going to throw you. It can push you backwards.
Lyell aggressive, not wasting any time for a setup, but all American girls are there to set it back. Bree Lyell over to Handevidt. Ooh, and some miscommunication as Anderson and Simonson got tangled up, and just like in baseball, when two outfielders collide, you have two position players colliding, and that results for another point to KDWB. They are rolling through the third set.
You know, in Hill Murray this year, they went to state in volleyball. They do have a strong volleyball program. They may be known for their basketball, but volleyball is right there. It's right behind it. A lot of times it depends upon the girls that you have that are playing.
And the same story over at Lakeville North, who won the state title this year in volleyball in Class 3A, even though their girls' basketball program was known as a stronghold for some time.
Yep, exactly. You know, I remember as a coach, you want those girls to be, you want your players to be those three-sport athletes, but so much, one of these sports can take and corrupt so much of that time. So it's really that balance that the girls have of which ones do they do and what.
That's why I stick to Wheel of Fortune. Lyell, Handevidt saves it and gets it off McKee. 10 straight points for KDWB, and on that last point, Handevidt with the save, and McKee, I think, got caught up in the sand. Her jump didn't go very high.
If you notice, Julia, she's now that they switch sides, she has the luxury of serving in the shade.
And now 11 straight points. If this keeps up, Walfoort may never have to play another position again. She's been serving this entire set. And I jinxed her. I'm going to get an angry letter from the Walfoort family now. That breaks the 11-point rally of KDWB. And the All-American girls, who started this match winning the first set, has their work cut out for them. And just like you're talking about, serving in the sun.
Yep, and Lydia, she looks a little tired. These girls, they don't have a rotation here on the All-American girls, so that sun might be draining them a little bit.
Handevidt serves out of bounds, and a service error gives a point to the All-American girls. It's 11-2.
I'm just still so amazed at how well they're doing. This is the first time outside that we've been for the camp, and they're all just playing fabulous.
Ryan, yes. Ryan with the behind-the-back lob, and the All-American girls are now getting some rhythm. They still have an 8-point deficit, but getting those first couple points gives you some confidence.
Of them back to back got in trouble when the ball came over and hit left front. When they're standing back too far, hitting that, digging that left front is a difficult dig to make.
And Ryan gets the net serve. Lyle's setting up to Walfoort. And McKee not there to dig it this time. Walfoort with just a little misdirection on that volley. We played a 15 in set number 3, so it's game point for KDWB, and it's short. All-American girls will have to score 10 points unanswered.
One side out, and game KDWB.
Ryan to serve. And it's ruled out of bounds. That's the match. KDWB comes back from a one-set deficit to win 2-1, and just a nice effort all around, and a fun first game in our doubleheader today.
Yeah, it was. These girls, they just came alive, didn't they? They were so fabulous.
They did, and I'm going to see if I can get a word with some of these players over here, if they don't mind. Let's see if we can get a word with our winning team, and perhaps some folks in the All-American girls, as we've got our camera person up. I've got Bree Lyell with me, and Savannah Handevidt, and the entire KDWB team. So how long did it take you to find a rhythm? It looked like you got that developing in the second set.
The last match.
They were killing us on the short stuff, so we had to adjust.
And how did the rotation, I guess, you had 5 players, so you had one person to sub in. How did that help keep you fresh?
It helped our setter keep fresh, so that was good for us, and just get a change up in the lineup. So.
And most importantly, what does this camp do to help keep your volleyball skills in shape? And how is this, you know, what's it like to play out in the sun, nice day, low humidity?
It's a lot different from inside, that's for sure. And it's a lot more harder in the sand. It's harder to run around, but it's really a good experience. It gets you trained for indoor because you do a lot better and you're a lot faster inside.
And is there anyone you want to say hi to that might be watching this? I know there's got to be some fans out there.
Hi, Mom.
Yeah, hey, Mom.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Mom.
That's it? Just your mothers?
Yeah, they're the only ones that are important. Come on now.
Well, remember, it takes two people to make people. Anyway, we appreciate you taking the time to speak with us. I'm sure this was a lot of fun out there. And what would you say to any young volleyball hopefuls about this camp or even just traditional court or beach volleyball? What would you tell them about it?
Communication.
Yeah, adjustment, learning your players, your teammates, and flowing.
Yep. Working on basic skills.
Fundamentals and always trying your hardest and always have a good time and like don't be afraid to mess up because it happens to all of us.
Yeah, definitely I would say keep the basics and the fundamentals, practice over and over.
Well, congratulations on your win, and we're going to bring the All-American girls in if we can.
So often athletes ask us at the Olympic, professional, even amateur level, how do I perform when it counts most? How do I make the big play? Hey, I would love to have a peak performance in competition. Well, as player performance coaches, we do encourage athletes to not only work on the conditioning and their skill development, but they also need to look at the inner game or the psychology of competition. Remember this, what you do off the court predicates what happens on the court. If you are emotional in front of parents, you'll be emotional with your coaches. If you don't perform well in a classroom on a test, you may not perform very well in the stress of a competition. Therefore, we are saying in your training, don't forget your training as far as conditioning or the skill. The mental side, and you're going to make big plays when you want to.
Here they are. We've got Ciara McKee. We've got Lydia Anderson, Annie Ryan, and Lauren Simonson. Lauren got sick. So who do we have? Maggie Mueller. That's right. So, I hope you don't mind being Lauren Simonson for a day, at least for the match. But talk about the match. You know, what was it like out there just playing beach volleyball on a day like today?
Oh, it was a lot more difficult than regular volleyball, but it's really fun. And the weather was nice, beautiful today for it.
Yeah, I was nervous because those girls are a lot older than us and a lot taller than us. And I'm just like, just go out there and have fun.
I just thought the sand was really hot. It hurt my feet.
It was a good day. It was fun, but you do get tired and it gets really hot. And so it tires you out pretty quickly.
This is why I've got the tennis shoes on. They get a little sandy, but they are a great shield against the sand.
Sand all over us. I don't think we have enough.
All right, so what did you, I guess, learn, and what does this camp do to help keep your volleyball skills going?
Definitely controlling the ball more and being ready.
Yeah, this camp is really, like, abstract. It's a lot different than, like, anything I've ever been to, so... I mean, we're outside, we're with guys, it's totally different.
I think that it's a lot different, but it helps you when from sand to court, you have to move a lot quicker on the sand than you do off the court, so it makes you a lot faster when you actually hit the court.
Yeah, and you also have less people when you're on sand, so you do need to cover more of the court, and it teaches you how to move your feet faster.
And lastly, anyone you want to say hi to that might be watching this program on television or online?
My old coaches, maybe? I don't know.
I'm sure they want to enjoy the shout out. What about you?
Hi, Grandma.
And Maggie, who was Lauren Simonson for a day?
Hi, Mom and Dad.
We can maybe include a shout out to Lauren, too, since you took her place.
Lauren, I'm sorry that you're sick, but I played for you.
I'll see you in driver's ed tomorrow, Mitzi. And hi, Mom and Dad, and all my old coaches for helping me.
Well, thank you for speaking with us, and congratulations on a three-set match, and just having some fun and showing that you can play volleyball on two surfaces.
Yeah.
That's the All-American girls, and that will conclude our coverage of the All-Girls match. We have the co-ed match coming up. For everyone here at TSB Television, I'm Mike Peden. Thank you for watching.